Prime Minister Narendra Modi is set to campaign in Odisha, Chhattisgarh and Maharashtra today. Prime Minister Modi will address a public meeting in Sundargarh in Odisha, and this will be followed by a rally in Sonepur in the state. Election to the 14 Lok Sabha seats and 147-member Odisha Assembly would be held in four phases starting from 11th of April. The Odisha rallies will be followed by a public meeting in Balod district in Chhattisgarh. Now, this will be Prime Minister Modi's first rally in Chhattisgarh after the Lok Sabha election dates were announced last month. Balod district falls in Kanker Lok Sabha constituency, which will vote in the second phase. And in the evening today, Prime Minister Modi will address a public meeting in Nanded in Maharashtra. With less than a week to go for the Lok Sabha elections to begin, political parties are gearing all out to woo the voters. On BJP's Foundation Day, Party President Amit Shah will hold two roadshows in Ahmedabad. The roadshows will cover several areas of Ahmedabad city, which falls in the Gandhinagar Lok Sabha constituency, from where Amit Shah is contesting. The first roadshow will begin from Sarkej on the outskirts of Ahmedabad, and it will end at Haveli. And in the evening, Amit Shah would take part in another roadshow, which will pass through Sabarmati area. Congress President Rahul Gandhi will campaign for his party in Uttarakhand today. He will address public rallies in Pauri Garhwal, Amroha and Almora and Haridwar. Rahul Gandhi and UPA Chairperson Sonia Gandhi will hold a public meeting at the Talkatora Stadium in New Delhi. Congress in charge for Eastern Uttar Pradesh, Priyanka Gandhi Vadra, will campaign in Fatehpur. And BSP Chief Mayawati will also hold election campaigns in Uttarakhand today. She will address the rallies in Haridwar and Rudrapur. Her rallies in Uttarakhand come just a day ahead of the formal launch of the campaigning of the opposition's Mahagathbandhan from Saharanpur. In a major move just before elections, the Election Commission on Friday night issued a letter to the Chief Secretary of West Bengal ordering the removal of four IPS officers, including commissioners of Kolkata Police and Bidhan Nagar Commissionerate. Election Commission transferred Kolkata Police Commissioner Anuj Sharma and Bidhan Nagar Police Commissioner as well. A compliance report in respect to the joining of the transferred officers will be sent now to the Election Commission within the next 24 hours. The Election Commission also directed that the present incumbent officers being shifted should not be involved by the state government in any election-related duty. Meanwhile, opposition parties in West Bengal have welcomed the move. BJP National Secretary Rahul Sinha said that this would gain the confidence of voters. And in another order, the Election Commission also relieved Andhra Pradesh Chief Secretary Anil Chandra Punnetha of the election duties and appointed a senior IAS officer L.V. Subramaniam as the new Chief Secretary. And our colleague Akhilesh Suman is now joining us live from Alipurduar in West Bengal. A very good morning, Akhilesh. So, Election Commission replacing Kolkata Police Commissioner and three other top officers in West Bengal. Of course, this after the parties alleged that, you know, free and fair elections would not be possible under these officers. And of course, the opposition parties have welcomed the move.
Right. You know that I was talking to all the political parties here and, BJP, CPIM, other components of left front, Congress, everyone has been having this fear that if the police is not guided properly, the free and fair election may be a dream for West Bengal. And I think they had complained time and again, also in Delhi and also in Kolkata in Election Commission. And I think this is the result of those complaints. And, if you talk to the people also complain many of the times that they are afraid to go to the polling booth if they are not supporter of the, ruling party. So this was a general feeling in the state. And I think Election Commission has changed the feeling and has tried to assure the people of West Bengal that we are transferring those officials about whom you suspect that they might help the ruling party. And that is why this transfer has taken place. You know that one of the most important transfer, I am telling you, it is the transfer of superintendent of police of Diamond Harbour. And Diamond Harbour is one of the most prestigious constituencies of Trinamool Congress, and the sitting MP is the nephew of Trinamool Congress leader and Chief Minister of West Bengal, Mamata Banerjee. He is Abhishek Banerjee, and Abhishek Banerjee is considered to be the person who commands all party cadres from behind, and also he has a very big clout in his constituency, and transferring of superintendent of police in his district is a big message to people of West Bengal all over that yes, we can transfer this police commissioner also, this superintendent also. So I think people will have confidence, and people will try to go to the polling booth and cast their vote. And this is not the only thing that they will reach the polling booth. People will complain that people who are in their homes, they are also told by some of the cadres of ruling party that you don't need to go to the vote. Polling booth, you don't need to go to booth if they sense that this vote will not go to the ruling party.
Yes.
So this type of fear is there in West Bengal. Mm. You talk to anyone, they will express such type of fear if they are not associated with ruling party. And
all
I think Election Commission, this order is a big thing, and I think this will impact the administration of the state, and it will also impact the police administration in the state, and police may act impartially as far as electioneering process is concerned, Aishwarya.
Right. Thank you so much, Akhilesh, for all those updates there. Of course, the Election Commission moving to ensure that free and fair elections will be held. Thank you so much, Akhilesh. And the Samajwadi Party released its election manifesto on Friday and called for greater change through social justice or Mahaparivartan. The Samajwadi Party is calling it a vision document. Releasing the 16-page document in Lucknow, SP Chief Akhilesh Yadav said that the future of the country should be better for all sections, including farmers and Muslims. The party also promised a 100% loan waiver for farmers, equal status and opportunities for women, and monthly pension of 3,000 rupees to needy women. It also talked of free and quality education, 1 lakh jobs per year, doubling of human resource in government departments in a phased manner, besides laptops and tablets for students.
Ke kisan khushal tabhi hoga jab uska pura ka pura karz maaf ho jaye. Samay samay pe jo jo sarkaren chunav mein gayi unhone vaade kiye kisan ko aur kaha ki hum karza maaf karenge. लेकिन नियम ऐसे बना दिए कि किसानों के कर्ज माफ नहीं हुए. हम उदाहरण में नहीं जाना चाहते, ना उत्तर प्रदेश के उदाहरण में जाना चाहते हैं, ना मध्य प्रदेश के उदाहरण में. लेकिन किसान का पूरा कर्ज माफ हो, इस पक्ष में हम लोग हैं.
And the Pragatishil Samajwadi Party Loya, led by Shivpal Singh Yadav, on Friday also released its manifesto for the upcoming Lok Sabha elections. And releasing the manifesto, Yadav said that his party will work for the welfare of all sections of society after coming to power.
और यह प्रसपा अगर सत्ता में आई तो कानून बनाकर जातिगत जनगणना उस पर आधारित आरक्षण को लागू किया जाएगा, जो लोहिया के विशेष अवसर के सम्मान सिद्धांतों के अनुरूप होगा. निजी क्षेत्र में भी आरक्षण, नौकरियों में कमजोर वर्ग के लिए सिर्फ आरक्षण से सामाजिक समानता और मौकों की समानता की लत को पाया नहीं जा सकता. वंचितों के सशक्तिकरण की जिम्मेदारी सरकार के साथ साथ प्राइवेट क्षेत्र पर भी है. ऐसे में सार्वजनिक क्षेत्र के अनुरूप निजी क्षेत्र में भी आरक्षण की व्यवस्था की जाएगी.
Lok Sabha Speaker Sumitra Mahajan will not contest the upcoming Lok Sabha elections. Eight-time MP from Indore, Mahajan on Friday opted out of the contest, saying that she had freed the party to make its choice. Mahajan said that she has conveyed her decision to BJP President Amit Shah, but maintained that she will continue to work for the party and campaign for it.
पार्टी को मैंने ये चिंता से मुक्त किया कि ताई को कैसा लगेगा मत सोचो, ताई पार्टी के लिए है. पार्टी ने बहुत कुछ मुझे दिया, ये जान से हम सभी मिल करके चुनाव लड़ेंगे, मगर कुछ निर्णय लेने में अगर संकोच किसी कारण से होता हो तो वो मेरी तरफ से मैंने कह दिया संकोच मत करो, नहीं लड़ूंगी मैं.
And West Bengal Chief Minister Mamata Banerjee addressed election rally in Dhubri in Assam. TMC Chief termed the NRC and Citizenship Bill as temptations to fool the citizens of Assam. She also mentioned that NRC had left out the names of 40 lakh people and that only TMC stood by them. Remember, Trinamool Party is contesting on 9 out of the 14 Lok Sabha seats in the state of Assam, which will go to polls in 3 phases from 11th of April to 19th of May.